Hey fellow reefers, we are here at the CIPS International Exhibition here in China. I'm with Neil Marks from Red Sea. Red Sea have just launched this incredible new ReefControl range. One part of the range are the new Red Sea probes. Can you explain to me the difference between the new Red Sea probes and the older analog ones?
They are digital. There's no longer a match between a port on the controller and the sensor itself. Any sensor can plug into any port. Okay. You don't have to decide which sensors you want to use today because you can buy another one tomorrow and add it into the system. If we come out with any new sensor in the future, you can just add it onto the same system without any extra hardware. The part of the controller that actually converts the analog data into a reading is all happening here. You don't have a whole load of wires running from your sump all the way to the control panel, so you're not susceptible to the kind of electromagnetic interference that you get with a typical analog system. You just have one wire on your controller, and then you have an expansion port, and there you connect in whatever sensor you want. You want to do calibration. Yep. All of the calibration data is held here. So you can move it from this controller to that controller, you don't need to recalibrate. All of these sensors actually have Bluetooth capability. You can actually disconnect the sensor from the controller, that you can even plug it into the USB.
And then you've got your sensor connected to your iPhone, and you can walk away and do your calibration.
Absolutely.
Okay,
absolutely.
Wow.
If you've got your mixing station for your water change down in the basement, you just take that probe, take it with you, check the salinity before you even bring it up to the aquarium for the next water change. So you don't need to buy another probe.
Right. So, wow.
Yeah.
It's a lot of flexibility built in there. Run us through the actual different probes that are part of the set on offer at the moment.
Sure. Probe number one here is the salinity and temperature.
Okay.
We moved away from the simple two-pole system, which is not too reliable and it's difficult to use, particularly for seawater. This is a four-pole graphite electrode product that we've developed ourselves. It also has the temperature built into the probe because, of course, salinity is absolutely temperature dependent.
Yeah.
So without the temperature adjustment, the reading is absolutely useless.
Right.
This
wow.
is a much more advanced technology. It's used in much more sophisticated type of
wow.
equipment, and we've managed to...
So basically, this is a highly accurate salinity probe with a built-in temperature compensation, giving you a very good and stable salinity measurement.
Absolutely. We've got pH and temperature also together because pH is affected by temperature.
Small amount, yeah.
but you're getting the temperature compensated. An individual temperature sensor. This won't be used so much with our ReefControl. When we talk a minute about the power, it has a lot more relevance for that. The OLP, pretty much the same as the pH.
Yep.
We've done the same things, didn't need the temperature compensation here because it's not relevant.
Yep.
The OLP gives a very good indication of the
overall
of the
water
organic,
quality. So. Yeah, I think there's a lot of people out there that actually, you know, they're looking at ORP, maybe not following what it really means, but you know, now that's going to be more available, they might be able to use
yep.
ORP as a better judgment of their overall
Again,
sort of
Again, the beauty of the system
health,
here
yeah.
is you don't need to buy a system with a dedicated ORP port for it. The decision now to monitor ORP is just buying that specific
awesome.
Probe without the whole system that goes
yeah.
behind it. And we also have an ATO module. We've taken our sensor from our regular ATO system
okay. yeah.
and made this one digital as well. You can now take one of these controllers,
yep.
you can add our digital ReefSense ATO sensor.
Yep, the
okay.
ATO, yep.
The controllers have got 12 volt outlets,
yep.
so that you can put your ATO pump there, and now you've got the complete ATO system.
Neil, I just realized there are tens of thousands of people maybe out there which have the Red Sea Reef ATO. They love it.
Okay.
So what does that mean for them?
What it means is that they can carry on using their Reef ATO. It's a great piece of equipment and it
yep.
does the job. But if you want to, for example, get rid of one extra controller off of your board, you can now buy this one, which is a relatively cheap item, and you can now take all of your existing ATO system and combine it with the ReefControl Pro or Lite controllers and have the ATO as part of that program of products.
Right, okay.
The other thing you can do, of course, you can buy this separately and you can use this to control even a larger AC pump because
yep.
you can connect it up to our ReefControl power unit
yep.
and then have ATO based on a much bigger pump or a non-Red Sea pump or whatever. So right. It really expands the possibility of ATOs.
Okay, wow. And now we just want to look at the actual controllers. We've got two different controllers here. Neil, take us through the
sure.
controllers.
The first one is our what we call the ReefControl Lit.
Okay.
This unit has the ability to have two of our ReefSense
probes
connected yep. to it, and has one outlet for any 12-volt device, whether it be a pump or a solenoid. This unit comes together with a pH and temperature setter probe. Second one is the ReefControl Pro.
Okay.
And this one has a lot more capabilities. First of all, you can see it has two 12-volt outlets so that you can control
yep.
directly
two
devices.
Yep.
And the other thing is it can have a total of seven of our ReefSense probes connected to it.
Okay.
The unit comes with a unit to connect four.
Four,
and
yep.
then you can just buy an extra port expander and then have
right.
it all the way up to seven.
So one of the connections here is used on the expander.
It's used on this one. Exactly.
You get the four plus the three, you've got a total
there
of seven.
You go. Now, the other thing is they've all got this port here, which
yep.
enables the controllers
yep.
to be connected directly to our ReefControl Power. We have a wired connection between the controllers and the ReefControl Power unit
right.
so that you can then control individual devices, individual sockets directly from
through the direct,
any
direct
one
connection.
Of the sensors and probes.
Now we over here, we have the ReefControl Power system.
So let me just talk you through it. This is a completely autonomous unit. It connects up directly to the internet.
So there's Wi-Fi inside the box?
Absolutely. You've got the on-off buttons for each one of the sockets from your phone. Okay,
right.
We do power monitoring on all of them, and you can set a schedule. Now you can bring any non-Red Sea device into that world of the Reef ecosystem.
Wow, so you can bring in other
of
brands,
course,
you could bring a chiller or maybe some fans at the moment.
Or a heater. When you're on the
Reef
system, we have things like our feed mode and maintenance mode.
System.
We've got someone else's return pump, okay?
Yep.
You just plug it in here and you can now switch it on and off as you want for maintenance or for feed or all the other things. The other unique thing that we've done here is we've given you a remote control panel. You can put this on your control panel with the rest of the controllers.
Yep.
It's got a 2-meter cable, so you can have the actual power bar way at the back where you don't really need
yep.
to see it or touch. If you're trying to do some tank maintenance,
yep.
you don't always want to get your phone out when you've got wet hands, and here you can just switch off a pump or the skimmer or whatever you want at the touch of a button.
Wow.
The other thing we have on this one is an interesting item, which is a grounding probe.
Okay.
So you've got a nice grounding probe, and the unique feature is that it has its own dedicated port on the side, so you're not taking up one of your sockets to ground the tank. So we have versions that work with the USA Japanese style of sockets.
Yep.
And we have another version which is for the European, Australian, UK. What you're seeing here, these are rubber covers.
Yeah, right.
So that any one of the sockets which is not being used has
a bit of water protection, a bit of splash protection.
Yeah.
Neil, the longer we keep talking, the more amazing features there are. But I think the reefers out there in the world, they're going to check this out. They're going to read the website. They're going to look at the videos. Congratulations. It looks awesome.
Great.
And keep up the good work.
Thank you.